Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and it's been a very, very long time that I posted any video on YouTube. So I was just busy with the regular schedule, and today I thought, why not? Today is Chutti, so why not make a video about the topic that I love the most, which is fragrance. So now that summers are coming up, of course we would. Not that in winters you don't require, I don't use perfumes, I do a lot of them, but I did cover a lot of reviews about the main or the important fragrances that I've been loving for winters so far. And today I thought of why not discuss a perfume which would cover the summers, spring, and of course you can use this perfume in winters as well. And I'm sure by the title you must have gotten to know what perfume we are really talking about here, which is nothing but the Burberry Body. This is how the bottle looks like. I just threw away the box already because it's been a while that I purchased this. And this is approximately 6,000 INR. But I did get this in discount. And this is the EDP version. And the bottle is very sleek. And it's a glass bottle with a golden or a rose gold nozzle, which is very trendy these days. And it's a very old fragrance, so I'm sure most of you must have used it already. But for the ones who have not used it, this would be the review. So as per the website, this I'm going to read the notes here because it's difficult to read the notes. Remember the notes as such. But as per the website, this perfume would be a fruity composition, which begins with the notes of fresh green absinthe, peach and freesia. Roses and iris would be in the heart, so that would be the middle note. And the base notes, which is strong, which is something that you would be able to observe because it is the strongest, and base notes are usually strongest in the perfume, which has sandalwood, cashmere, and amber, and of course like all the perfumes that I love, it has vanilla too. So but the best part is sandalwood is something which is very prominent in the base note, and from the very first spray you would be able to identify that this has sandalwood, because it's a mild fragrance, but it stays on for quite a long time. And of course It's a subtle sandalwood, which is classy and appropriate for winters, summers or spring. So I've been using this in spring, and I've used it this much already. But according to me, if I have to give you my personal review, then I would say it's a beautiful blend of roses just not simple rose. There would be a lot of there are a lot of perfumes in the market with rose fragrance, but this is definitely a fragrance with rose, and that too rose with depth, if you understand what I mean to say. So but like I told you, the performance is good. It's moderate. I would not say it's a long-lasting fragrance, but it lasts on my skin for about 5 to 6 hours, which I feel is quite decent. But in case if I spray this on my clothes, I can definitely smell, get the fragrance until I wash the clothes. So it's that great. And because it's mild, it would not hurt someone's nose. It's really, really classy, and I've been loving this so much. Like I've been telling you, this is actually a subtle scent. It's a neutral scent. It might or it might not gather compliments, but it has definitely gathered compliments on my skin, because I hope you would understand there are fragrances, a lot of fragrances would smell differently on different bodies, because the combination of the oils that your body produced, the heat that your body produced, the fragrance would act accordingly. So that's exactly why not every perfume on every body would smell the same. Not every perfume would smell similarly, but I can definitely say that this is a perfume which definitely would go ahead and I mean, it will not hurt somebody's nose. It will if not compliment, somebody would appreciate if you're sitting beside them wearing this perfume, because you would be smelling nice. And of course, to me, because a lot of the fragrances that I use, I do consider that they should, I mean, one of the factors that I choose to select the perfume is if it's good for an office wear or not, because office is something that you go every day and you end up using. I mean, you shop according to the office most of the time, because you spend most of your hours in a day in the office, and that's exactly one of the factors that I look at, and that's exactly why I would definitely put this in an office wear category, because it's subtle. It will not hurt somebody's nose, and that's why I would make this an office fragrance. I mean, I've been using this every day for the office, and I do consider this as an office fragrance, because it has a balance of every note. It definitely has a balance of what should I say, of all the blends. It's blended beautifully, and that's why it's really, really nice. Now, as in when you would spray this perfume, it would open with the rose note. I mean, you definitely would have a hint of rose with some woodiness to it, which is what which makes this perfume really unique. After getting that woody note, I would say it would, within 5 to 7 minutes or so, it would start getting musky, which again is a good musk. So it's I mean, a lot of musk is available in the men's section, but this would be a musk which is subtle and definitely appropriate for women, I would say. And then the moment the musk would go away, the amber would actually replace the musk, and amber would linger on for the whole time along with the sandalwood thingy. So that is what which makes this perfume so unique, so nice, and so subtle. Now, the reason, one of the reason that it which makes it a office wear is because that this fragrance is not overpowering at all. That's why it will not cause headaches. So that's why I love it. And I would say even, I mean, if the, I mean, I do like some perfumes which are overpowering, because I tend to use a lot of sprays, even though if for the strongest perfume that I have so far, which for which I do have other reviews on my channel already. If you would like, you can check other reviews too. In case, for example, the one that I have is let me just check the name, the Giorgio Armani C Intense. That is one of the strongest perfume that I have, and if 3 to 4 sprays would be enough, I end up spraying about 10 to 12 times. That is how I love perfumes, and that's I would still say it's not overpowering. Even if you would spray on for 7 to 8 sprays on your clothes, it is not overpowering, and that too in a good way. I mean, of course, you'll be able to continue the elasticity of the perfume, but it still smells really nice. now, like I mentioned, it is good for all seasons. So, but I would definitely prefer it for summers and spring, because recently I've got this, and since it's subtle, I would definitely make it my summer fragrance because this will last long. And let me tell you, in winters I tend to wear fragrances which are high notes of vanilla. So I've been enjoying my Zara vanilla, the red vanilla, and also I've been loving the sweet vanilla. But even though this perfume has vanilla notes, you would hardly be able to identify. So for the for someone who doesn't like vanilla notes, for someone who thinks that vanilla notes are really common in every perfume, you should not be afraid of buying this, because even though it has vanilla note, you would not be able to tell that it's vanilla. It just makes this perfume smell a little sweet and a little girly, I would say. Now this, as far as my knowledge goes, this is only available in the EDP version, because I've not come across any EDT version. So that's why I got EDP, and EDPs are usually stronger. I'm sure you know it already. So that is why I preferred the EDP version. And I'm not even sure whether this comes in different sizes. This is the 100 ml I have. Yeah, this is 100 ml, and I'm not sure whether it comes in other different sizes or not, but in case if you would want to buy it, this is definitely available on Myntra, Jabong, Nykaa. You can also go in Sephora or the Burberry counter. So do give it a try, and in case if you do, and if you like it, not like it, do leave it in the comment section. And before I close the video, let me remind you, thank you so, so much for the ones who've recently subscribed, and for the ones who've subscribed already. We've been family from day one. It really, really means a lot to me. And in case if you want to continue watching these kind of videos, please, please do subscribe to my channel. It would mean the world to me. And I will see you in the next video. Bye.